If you ask someone, how do trains stay on track and make turns? They'll most likely tell you it's because of its flanges. If you didn't know, the flanges refer to this protrusion on the wheel. Many mistakenly believe that whenever a train encounters a curved section, the flanges force the train to follow the curved tracks. But this is obviously wrong, since the friction from the flange rubbing against the track will be equivalent to stepping on the brakes, forcing the train to a screeching stop. As it turns out, the flanges are simply a safety feature designed to stop derailment. So how do trains turn? As with all vehicles with wheels, it needs to figure out a way to make the outer wheel travel a longer distance compared to the inner wheel. With automobiles, you have a differential gear that enables the left and right wheels to each rotate at different speeds, making turns possible. But trains don't have any such gears, and both wheels always make the same number of rotations. So instead, train wheels are tapered toward the outside. In other words, the diameter of the outer part of the wheel is in fact smaller than the inner part. So when a train encounters a curved section, inertia pushes the outer wheel onto its thicker side, while the inner wheel is pulled onto its thinner side. Since the circumference of a wheel depends on its diameter, the thicker part of the wheel will have a greater circumference, forcing it to travel farther compared to the inner wheel. As a consequence, our happy little train will successfully navigate the turn without derailing. However, inertia will force the train to continue the turn, even though it will have now entered the straight section of the tracks and now needs to travel straight in order to avoid derailment. So this time, the inner wheel will be pushed onto its thick side, while at the same time, the outer wheel will be pulled to rotate on its thinner side. Therefore, our train will now turn the other way toward the center of the tracks, effectively avoiding derailment. The train will wobble a bit thereafter, but will eventually travel true. So to answer the question, how do trains stay on track and make turns? It's because of its tapered wheel design. Stick science.